Some of us will be gone and others will take the ball. But we need to make sure that this generation is part of this process. We say that in 50 years, we think that Africa was rising. In 50 years, Africa will be prosperous with peace with itself. That have been the message. But also they added with a development were centered on the people themselves. Who are the people? The youth of today. You are the one who have to drive the development of this continent. So a lot need to be done. So I said I'm coming here because I want to listen and learn. But in the meantime, I can also share our small experience as a women movement, because we have been fighting for decade and our mothers fought for us. We fought for ourselves, and you are going to fight for yourself, because nobody will invite you at the table. You have to be there if you want to change the policy. And we need to change the policy, because they cannot be isolated, the old people like me, being isolated and not getting into what the young people want. You know, the leaders of Africa have to listen to the young people. They have to be making sure they contribute to the economy. So that's the reality that for me is important, and listening to the different experience around the table. We see that they are the doers and the makers. They are the future of our continent. We need to listen to them. So I will stop there, but I wanted to say we had obstacles. We had obstacles as women feminist movement in Africa. But we need to share that with you as mothers, as sisters, because that will make the number that will matter. And the decision maker will listen to all of us. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Binetta. Now, to make this conversation as easy as possible, I do know that there are many aspects of our lives that, you know, happens to us as young people, or many aspects we must go through. We have education, we have business, we have politics. Some of us have carved a niche for ourselves in some of those areas specifically, but nonetheless, they all overlap. Now, I want to start with education. They've been saying that education is the bedrock of a good foundation. But hey, I'm looking at everybody here, and I'm wondering how many people are really using their education, you know, to as platforms or as foundations or as the bedrock of where they are. Ashish, I'm going to start with you. I know that you're already getting a little uncomfortable. I know that you did leave school at the age of 15 to start your business. It was a leap of faith. Do you think that education is overrated?
I think all the parents are going to kill me, but yeah, absolutely it is. But no, I think, look, I mean, the only regret I have is I can't properly read or write, but other than that, it's all good. You know? I think, look, on a practical note, today's time is different, and I suppose everybody's circumstances are different in their own respects, but practically what we live today in our lives, how much of our education has really helped us, how much has it been functional, is a question mark, in my opinion. I believe that things like mentorship is a lot more important than education, because it's more practical, right? I mean, what you could learn from your teacher in school or what you could learn from Kola Karim is completely different. I mean, he'll teach you what the practicalities are. If he's your mentor, he will guide you in the right way with the realities of today, not the theory stuff, right? So in my opinion, I think, is it overrated? In my humble opinion, yes. But is there a bridge to be gapped? Yes, but I think mentorship is a lot more valuable than traditional education.
What do you think?
Martha, I think we need a mind shift where education is concerned. I remember, I mean, this is a conversation that I've had quite a number of times when it comes to this. A lot of us go to, for example, particularly university to get jobs. And I remember there was an event at Wits University that we had hosted, and one of the keynote was given by Minister Trevor Manuel. And he said, you come to university not so that you get a job. The certificate, the only thing it says is that you have the ability to learn. So if anything, we should change how we perceive it. We shouldn't be going to universities necessarily to get jobs, but it's about, are you learning how to think? Is a culture of thinking cultivated while you're there? And I'd say it's not, because far too often you're judging students on how many, like what percentage they get. So it's about 50% is pass mark, you know, an 80 is an A. And it's not about applying yourselves. And I know it's not so much applicable in certain, you know, in certain fields, for example, engineering, where you actually learn processes. But something like the humanities, why isn't that philosophy isn't emphasized more? Because that teaches you critical thinking. And that's a skill you use irrespective of where you work. And so I think we need a mind shift. But also, as a young woman, I wouldn't say it's not important when there are so many young women, not just in Africa, but across the world, who don't have access to education. And so we can't just say it's overrated. So many haven't even had the access to that education. I'm fortunate enough to have been able to go to primary, secondary, and I'm currently now at university. And so I think I'd be using my privilege incorrectly if I said education is overrated. It would be easy for me to say because I'm already in the system. I do think we need to be educating more girl children. And even the fact that girl children are abducted from a school speaks to how they see the power of an educated young woman. And that in itself is something that needs to interrogate it. When you look at communities across the world, when they target those communities and want to cripple sort of the ecosystem of that communities, young women, you know, are targeted, young girls are targeted. Why is it that of people who don't have access to education, it's mostly young girls? Because we realize the power that it actually has. And we can't forget that story that, you know, a little girl who comes from a village in KZN and ends up being, you know, heading, you know, multinational organizations because of the access to education that they've had. So I think it's not overrated as such. We're just not using it in the right ways. And that's why we know that if you want to sort of dampen a society or community's progress, you make sure that you block access to education, particularly to young women.
I'm going to come to you a little later on that. But Essie, you have a degree in physics, and you're definitely not doing physics right now.
No,
you're doing something very different. Mm-hmm. How much influence would you say that your education had in what you're doing right now?
Well, for me, when we think of education, the traditional way that it's been conducted may be overrated, but learning is not. And where I think the spaces where that learning happens, it's important to cultivate them. So for me, I didn't really think of myself as a leader until I went to school. So I went to a women's college in the US called Smith College. And it was really there that I kind of found myself, right? Because I looked all around me and there were these women and everybody had something that they cared about, right? There were people who were saving the world. There were people who were going back to, you know, their home countries to do things. And I think that being in that environment, so it wasn't really what I learned in my physics classes, but what I learned by being in that community of smart, motivated women, that made me ask myself, well, what do I care about? You know, and I think that was the beginning for me of, you know, trying to find my place in the world. And then coming back to business. So yes, I studied physics, but I think the emphasis was always that you are learning how to solve problems. And so when I came back, I thought, well, what problems do we have? So in other parts of the world, their problem might be trying to put a man on the moon. Our problems are food, clothing, shelter. You know, so yes, I may not be building the next sophisticated equipment, because the place that I come from, that's not what we need. And so I'm using the problem-solving skills that I learned to apply to my environment and to try to solve problems that I find in my environment. So am I using my physics? Yes, I am using the skills that I learned about how to solve problems in my environment.
Kola, I'm going to also ask you this question in connection with you as an entrepreneur and also an employer of labor, you know, from your own experience as, you know, one who's been through school and also one who employs people who have been through school, do you think that education needs to be rejigged?
Look, one important area that we always must recognize is there is the formal education and there's the informal education. I think a lot, the overrated position of this formal